Hey guys, so I looked online for how to replace a stereo in a 1990 Scottsdale. Mine's a K2500 Silverado, Scottsdale, Cheyenne, same. Anyway, you gotta take apart a lot of stuff to figure out where the wires are. And the wires are very short, but it can be actually fairly simple once you figure out where everything is and that the stereo isn't the stereo unit that you think it is. So this right here, I cut the wire because I got frustrated, really isn't the stereo. I think it's more of a control module than a stereo. And the reason why I say that is if you come down to here, remove this panel, you'll actually have what I believe is the actual stereo. Mine had the tape deck in it. And in any case, this is the controller. This went to here. All right. And this connection, once I found this damn thing, I found the tape deck connection. This is actually the stereo. This is just a control unit and your tape deck. And here I've disconnected the way that this sits is up and in, higher up, of course. And it has three connections right there, there, and there, which connect to, if I can get in there, 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 and there. Okay, so it's a very, if there's no instructions on how to do it, it can be a very much pain in the butt. And I used to install stereos back in the 90s, and I never did these models. So yeah, it's actually pretty simple once you figure out this is the unit that you need to get a hold of. Once you get disconnect those three connections. Now, some of these wires you won't have in yours because it's part of my lighting system in CB. But once you figure out those connections, disconnect those two. Instead of clipping your wires, disconnect those two, you know, your controller and your controller and tape deck. Then you have your access to your actual where you can get an adapter and just put an adapter on this, and then you can easily wire this up through your system to put it up in there. Anyway, just want to make that short video, it's probably a little longer than expected, about how to do that. A lot of my friends have these vehicles and maybe have tried to replace their stereo and went never mind. And if you go to a stereo place, they charge you an arm and a leg to do this in these type of model of trucks and vans and whatnot, SUVs. So yeah, it's actually pretty easy once you figure out this is actually your stereo. You just disconnect this, you have two connections, and all this stuff that I did here, I really did not need to do replacing removing all this, because if I just went right there, it would have been three disconnections and everything would have been hunky-dory. So just trying to save everybody a little bit of time. Everybody take care. So this is what to expect once it's all put in place. Now here's the panel that you should take down to get to that actual stereo unit. I ordered this piece here from Amazon, in my color of my the interior of my truck. I have a piece coming in to fill in that gap, to make like a little cubby hole there. But that's what to expect. Of course, I put just a 10-year-old stereo I had in here. It's, you know, probably worth 20 bucks on eBay. So just give you a kind of an idea what pieces you'll need and what to do to work on with your truck or van or SUV. Okay, talk to you later.